right, ladies and gentlemen, here we are at Ligonier Valley Middle School, all right? We're talking about equipment today, all right? But not the football kind, all right? The helmet, very critical for the football field. For class, not so much. If you need a football helmet in class, things might be getting a little out of hand, all right? But better safe than sorry. Here we go, Rams pride. Let's get it done here, okay? So yes, yeah, sadly, I'm gonna keep this on because, you know, I feel a lot safer here. We're gonna talk about some different chemistry equipment that we will use, be using throughout the year, okay? So if you haven't been able to gain access or practice with these, it's a little bit of a bummer, but hey, we'll at least go over them so you'll know what they are and what they do, okay? So first off, we have our triple beam balance, okay? Not triple bean, okay? That would be like black bean, baked bean, kidney bean, pinto bean, okay? Not triple bean, but bean, because there are 1, 2, 3 beams, okay? Used for finding the masses of small objects. Like this can go up to 610 grams, okay? That's not like Teddy grams, okay? Gram, we, you know, we're using metric here chemistry, okay? But 610 grams, that's like a pound and a half, okay, to put it in your language. Okay, about a pound and a half, so not too much, right? So it's for finding the masses, very precise and accurate masses, okay? Might be a little bit old school, a little bit outdated. You know, nowadays, you can kind of just use an electric one. You just set the item down and boom, it gets it for you. But you know what? That's too easy, right? That's too easy. So we work with the triple beams, okay? So we have our lab thermometer, okay? Different than a thermometer that you would use to take your temperature, because you know, the thermometers that you use, like if you put it under your tongue or your armpit, okay, to get your temperature, there's a little kink, all right? And that kink kind of traps the mercury, right? This is actually made of mercury. Mercury, on the periodic table, okay, it's a metal, but it's odd. It is a liquid at room temperature. All of the metals are solids at room temperature besides mercury, all right? So it's filled with mercury. And the lab thermometer, it measures, you know, it finds the temperature precisely at that moment. So if we have it in some boiling water, we take it out, you're gonna see the mercury going down, right? But a thermometer that you would use, as I mentioned, has that little kink, so it traps the mercury, right? So when you pull it out from your armpit or from your tongue, you can see, oh, there it is. It's not going down as you are trying to read it, okay? So a little bit different there, all right? We have a ring stand, okay? Beyonce would say, all you single ladies, put your hands up, okay? So put a ring on it. She should have put a ring on it, okay? So we got a ring stand. The ring stand, okay, we're gonna use, we would put a clamp, okay, on there. And it just kind of keeps different, like, glassware for heating glassware, something you'll probably do in high school chemistry. We don't have any Bunsen burners. We won't be burning anything necessarily, all right? So, there is our ring stand, all right? We also have a dropper pipette, okay? So, sit, roll over. Good dog. Dropper pipette. I can't drop. I got this football helmet. I'm all hands here, right? Dropper should be, like, the catcher pipette, okay? The catcher pipette, the receiver pipette, but it's the dropper pipette. We can just extract, okay, and put and place a small trace amounts of liquids, okay, with our dropper pipette, all right? How about our graduated cylinder? Well, $19.99 plus shipping and handling, all right? Only in select countries, okay? The graduated cylinder. How smart, right? He's all grown up, right? He's hit all these different marks in his life. He went to elementary school and middle school and did all these things in high school, and he's going off to college. He graduated. Right? The graduated cylinder, right, is used for finding, you know, precise and accurate measurements, okay, in milliliters. All right, we use it to find the volume, okay? The volume. We use it to find the volume. And so most of them are glass, but we have some plastic ones here, right? We have the beaker. It almost looks like a little bird, right? Look at that little beak there. The beaker, okay? We also use it. We can find the volumes of liquid. This is 150 milliliter. It's like small. I feel like I'm working at an ice cream shop, right? We got small, we got medium, we got large, we got extra large, all right? They're For cones, okay, I guess extra large, that would be pizza. I don't know if I've ever gotten an extra large cone, but if you find one, let me know, okay? So there we have the beaker again, used for, you know, pouring, okay? You know, liquids, all right? We also, kind of getting ahead of myself here, where am I at? This helmet, I tell you what, this is a little weird. Did that, we have the, a flask, okay? It is an Erlenmeyer flask, okay? Has kind of a, it kind of bows out at the bottom and it's skinny at the top, okay? So we use it to like heat, boil, and mix chemicals, sorry. And so it has like kind of the skinny neck, but the wider base, all right? We also have the test tube, not the quiz tube, okay? Not the pop quiz tube, but not the Go-Gurt tube, the test tube, okay? We can't measure with this, right? So we are not gonna be doing too hot with this. We need other things. We need things like the graduated cylinder, right? To pour and get our measurements and place them into the test tube, right? Okay, next one we have the forceps, I should hold on. The forceps, used for extracting small little things, little pieces here and there. We would maybe use them to extract something out of a petri dish, okay? Or picking up, it could really be used for anything, but something that would be hard to get just with your finger. So we got the forceps, okay? Not the threeps, not twoceps, not the biceps, not the triceps. The forceps, okay? All right? You can call them, tweezers, all right? Whatever you want to call it, but forceps is kind of the name that we use here, all right? We have our tongs, okay? Used if we had a beaker that was with some boiling water, okay? There we go, we pick it up. You don't want to use your phalanges, right? You don't, those don't grow back all the time. So if you learn one of those, not gonna feel so good, okay? So we have the tongs, okay? You can almost kind of make a T, the tongs. Kind of, not really, right? Here we have the hot plate, okay? The hot plate, okay? We're gonna use this, you know, to put some different liquids, okay? Maybe we need to heat up some water. They can go pretty quick. This one goes up to 500 degrees Celsius, all right? So it gets hot. And we can put a beaker in there. We can put another one in our flask, okay? So we can heat them. We just have to plug that in. This one, it's so fun. It's a funnel. Everyone say, the funnel. Say like a question, the funnel? Say like the Kool-Aid man, the funnel. Oh yeah, all right, we got the funnel. Use, you know, again, it has this wider base top, but if I need to, you know, pour a liquid into something. All right, now this is actually a little bit too big of a funnel. All right, but if I'm pouring something out of like a cup or something where it's gonna be hard, I don't wanna spill out anything, I use the funnel, okay, to get a precise pour, okay? And ladies and gentlemen, I think that is all for our equipment. Okay, wanted to go over those. Boom, boom, boom. All right, I think that is everything. So the equipment, I hope you're ready. Buckle up, get your chin straps on. It's chemistry equipment time. Suszek out.